Well, as you heard earlier today in Medical Alert, more Americans today die from hepatitis C than from HIV. Around 600 million people around the world have hepatitis B or C, and most of us are never screened for the disease, partly because there's a belief that there's nothing you can do about it. But one doctor here in Baltimore believes everyone should be screened because there is a cure. Wallace Harding found out he had hepatitis C about 9 years ago when, at a routine checkup, the nurse mistakenly tested him for it.
Came back in the office, my doctor looked at me, hepatitis C, and I was like, no way. And I didn't, I went to denial on it. You know, I didn't believe it at first. I didn't want to believe it.
With no symptoms, which isn't unusual, Wallace had no idea how he contracted hepatitis C, but he does have tattoos.
Maybe those old tattoo parlors back in the day. Nothing against tattoos these days. I'm sure everything's clean these days. But, you know, from back in the day, we call it, you know, and talking about the 70s, you know, lifestyles were a little crazier.
Hepatitis B and C are spread through contaminated blood, so an infected needle from a tattoo or a piercing could be the cause. At the time, the only treatment available to Wallace was interferon injections, which have serious side effects, and Wallace didn't respond to the drug, so he stopped treatment. And the possible outcomes for hepatitis B and C aren't good: cirrhosis of the liver, liver cancer, and liver failure. Which is why Dr. Paul Tulevath wants testing for hep C and B to become routine.
Ideally, everybody should be tested. This is a simple blood test which can either rule in or rule out hepatitis C or B.
He says part of the issue is that doctors have other conditions to worry about, like hypertension, diabetes, heart disease. But the other problem is there's no diagnosis code to support a routine test.
If they have abnormal liver enzymes, then they can check. But if somebody comes with a normal liver test, perfectly healthy, they don't have what we call ICD code.
ICD stands for International Classification of Diseases. Those are codes that insurance uses to determine payment. So if a test is run for the disease without a reason to, they may deny payment. Dr. Tulevath says what's needed is educating doctors and insurance companies.
In the long run, they will benefit. If we detect people at an early stage, we can prevent the progression to cirrhosis, liver failure, and liver cancer.
Which will save money in the long run by reducing the need for liver transplant, which is extremely expensive. And although Dr. Tulevath believes that everyone should be routinely screened, IV drug users are especially at risk. Anyone who had a blood transfusion before 1992 or lived in a country with lower health care standards should be tested. Healthcare workers who handle needles are also at risk. Less commonly, the virus can be spread through unprotected sex. Dr. Tulevath says spouses of hepatitis sufferers should definitely be tested.
When I went through the treatment the first time...
Years after deserting treatment, Wallace Harding found his way to Dr. Tulevath's office this past July, where they found his disease had progressed. He became part of a new study that had him on a 3-drug cocktail plus interferon. In 2 weeks, he had a call from Dr. Tulevath's nurse.
She said, "Wallace, we have good news for you, and your viral load has gone from 4 million, which is a count load that they do,
right,
down to 300. And the next day I was totally cleared from the virus."
I mean, that's kind of like a miracle for you, isn't it?
Kind of, yeah. I had to admit, when she told me that, I broke down and cried like a baby for about 10 minutes. I tell you, it had to be one of the better moments of my life.
And several months out, Wallace is still clear of the hepatitis C virus. And Dr. Tulevath says that a code for routine screening for hep C will be in the IDC code in 2013. Not this year, though. And he believes that within 5 years or so, patients will be on pills only, no injections, possibly even one pill that will take 3 to 6 months to be completely cured of what used to be an incurable disease.